Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be my favorite series here for the year of 2021. We are back at it with Dudes Who Are Down Bad, episode number 2. And yeah, man, before we jump into the rest of the video, don't forget to drop a like. Let's aim for, 50 likes on this video. We're going to set the bar low here and rise up slowly but surely. And I know at least 50 of you are going to be watching this. All right. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and that bell. And hell, guys, follow this account, Dudes Down Bad. It is one of the funniest accounts on Twitter. It's spiked in followers like overnight. It's already at 1 million. And it just gives me a good laugh every single time they tweet. And we're about to have a good laugh here as well. Let's jump into it. So we're going to start off with a banger here right out the gate. Man, if this happened to me, I don't even know what I would do. I would probably just leave this group chat. I don't even know, man. Like, this is just the worst possible scenario I could think of, being in a group project in high school or college. Like, if this happened to me, I would probably just make a joke out of it because it's just that bad. All right. So, it's a group chat, but this person that's, typing here, the blue bubble, I guess, is the person. They basically were trying to hit up one of the girls in the group chat, but instead were in the group chat itself. So he goes, "Hey, Riley, now that the group project is over, I was wondering if you maybe wanted to hang out more." And Riley responds, obviously, because she definitely feels bad because she already knows what's going to happen. But she says, "Hey, I had fun doing the project, but I have a boyfriend." And then everyone else proceeds to just take a massive dump on this poor guy. They go, "Arjun, you sent this in the group chat." Lauren goes, "Oh my God, ha ha ha." Ellie goes, "Ha ha ha, I feel so bad, but ha ha ha." Like, dude, I don't even know. This isn't even a scenario of the guy, like, constantly responding to the girl with no responses in return. This is just a really bad scenario. I am pretty self-conscious of, like, who I respond to when I'm texting and, all that fun stuff, but this is just a whole other level of down bad, and I just have no other words to describe it. So the next one comes up from an Instagram DM, which is probably one of the more riskier tactics that guys are using in the year of 2021. I don't personally do this myself. I don't know. It just comes off weird and creepy, but hey, do what you gotta do, guys. So he basically just greets himself by saying, "Good evening." Like, what are you, Dracula, my guy? Chill out. That sounds so creepy. But then I guess the girl goes, "Do I know you? If you're gonna attempt to flirt, then just leave." He goes, "It's me, Mason. We talk like every day." It's gotta be one of those odd fellas that you see, in the lunchroom, or maybe you see around campus, because I don't know, the good evening thing just has me off the wrong foot. And then, she goes, "Oh, you, sorry, I removed everyone I thought was unimportant." So how does this girl, or this person, I don't even know if it's a girl because she's got a dog as her avi or a profile picture. She basically just goes, "I really just removed everybody that's unimportant in my life." But I mean, how could you say that to someone that you talk to every day? Pretty interesting. And he just goes, "Sheesh." Like, damn, that's rough. But yeah, man, don't just, if you're gonna go into the Instagram DMs, try not to pull some type of Dracula-ish where you're gonna just suck the blood out of the person's neck. Like, goddamn, man. All right, this next one, this person is talking, I guess guy, because it's Dudes Down Bad. This guy's talking to Brooke through, again, Instagram DMs. And he goes, "We hanging tonight?" Question mark. She goes, "Not sure." He goes, "Well, let me know." And then he responds like 4 hours later, and he's like, "Any update?" I don't know, man. Like, if you're going, "Well, let me know," if she doesn't respond, that's pretty much the hint right then and there. So any update almost seems like you're already kind of bugging her. But then he goes 4 extra hours later at 10 p.m. He goes, "It says you listen to my sex playlist on Spotify, haha." She goes, "Sorry, long night," the next day. Damn, like, you already know what happened. She had an extra person above this fella on her list. and, you know, is using the sex playlist that the guy she turned down with another dude. I mean, that's just ultimate disrespect. I mean, at the end of the day, at least she's kind of just being upfront with the dude and not like playing him or whatever, or, you know, whatever, just trying to put icing on the cake, so to speak. She just didn't beat around the bush, and just honestly, this was a rough one, man. The disrespect was real. All right, this next guy is texting Bridget, all right? So it's 3 p.m. in the day. She goes, just finished studying. How about you? I guess they were already texting, and maybe this is just like her like delayed response. Because as you know, when you don't respond for like an hour, it then says iMessage today or whatever if you're on the iPhone. He goes, new music, and starts self-promoting his SoundCloud to this chick. I don't know, man. That's a risky situation there, right? Because even if you're talking to this girl, maybe you should keep your SoundCloud on the DL unless you're like really blowing up on there and have a lot of clout. Maybe it's like a flex, but if you're one of those guys on the come up and you got like, I don't know, 30 listens or whatever it is, maybe you shouldn't be sending that to the chick that you're interested in. That's just, I don't know, a little tip from Cryptix over here. So she responds and goes, okay, you usually have great taste in music, but that song is pretty shit. And he goes, thanks, Bridget. I wasn't listening to it though. I made it. That's my song. Oof, that one just hurts, man, because a bunch of guys are, you know, or even people for that matter, are doing these side hustles. Imagine this girl just shutting your side hustle down. That's pretty rough, man. Like, I ain't gonna lie. So this next dude is texting Abby. He goes, LMAO, I love the pic you posted of us on Insta. She goes, I know, I love it. He goes, my friend asked if we were a couple. You already know what this dude was trying to do when he sent that text. You already know he was trying to see where he felt or she felt the situation was at in their friendship. But she goes, what did you tell him? Does it look like that? Should I delete it? Ooh, the last one just stings, man. What friend? Oh, damn. All right, so we gotta break this down. This guy was trying to see, you know, if this girl was gonna respond in maybe a better way to enhance or maybe move forward in their relationship, maybe be like an actual couple. And she just completely is throwing bombs at him. She goes, what did you tell him? Does it look like that? Like already, she's already flustered in this situation. She is overthinking everything. And then the next one goes, should I delete it? Like, she doesn't want anything of that on her profile. But the last one, man, the last one is the uppercut, the Mike Tyson 1-2. This guy's out on the canvas. She goes, what friend, man? Like, you already know she's interested in one of these dudes' friends. And that, oh, damn, man. Like, I feel bad, but at the same time, like, I don't know, it's just too risky to be saying, oh, my friend asked if we were a couple. Like, don't even do that. Don't even do that. But yeah, that last text, what friend? You already know she's interested in one of your boys, bro. Just give it up. All right, this next one, man, is an Instagram DM. And I don't know, man, like, I'm more of the dating app person myself personally. But hey, sometimes people gotta shoot their shot. But at the end of the day, not everyone is Stephen Curry, if you know what I'm saying. This guy goes, hey. She goes, my bad, I was in the shower, but hey, how are you? And I don't know, the timing looks a little weird because he sent this text on March 8th and this girl responds literally like way later, like on the day. She goes, my bad, I was in the shower, but hey, how are you? So he responds with, since March, LMAO, you already know. She was not interested in this dude. She just made up some lame excuse that she was in the shower for months, I guess, you know? I maybe that's like some type of anti-aging method that these girls are finding in 2021. But yeah, this guy is already, I guess, suspicious because no one showers since March, if you know what I'm saying. All right, the next one is pretty short, sweet, simple, and to the point. And like, damn, dude, like, I feel like I say damn so many times in this video, but these girls have no remorse, man. This guy is texting a chick, I'm assuming. He goes, yo, you want to FaceTime? She goes, she texts with her phone and responds. It says, sorry, I can't find my phone. And he goes, oh, okay. Like, he already knows what's going on. I mean, the only loophole I can see in this scenario is because some people may have their Macs and can actually iMessage through their MacBook or MacBook Pro or whatever it is. So that could be a potential excuse this girl can come up with. But at the end of it all, like, sorry, I can't find my phone. He goes, oh, okay, with no response. That's the done deal, bro. You just got a ghoster after that one. All right, this next one is from Charlotte over here. Just instant disrespect. He goes to Charlotte, we should do it again sometime. That was a lot of fun. So obviously it's after the date. Usually, you know, if the guy handles the plans in the situation, after the date, you should, and this is a cryptics tip, all right? You should let the girl respond and let her thank you for the date. That's just something that I've realized, but he goes, we should do it again sometime. That was a lot of fun. She responds, worst 2 hours of my life. OMG, wrong person, sorry. That wasn't about tonight. It was about something else. He goes, gotcha. I mean, clearly she was trying to text the group chat or someone else. Worst 2 hours of her life on a date. That's just, oof, that guy's gonna definitely need to go to some therapy after that one. I guess he must have done something wrong. Maybe he wasn't talking. Maybe he wasn't enthusiastic. Who knows? But yeah, Charlotte with the disrespect. The next one's from Steph. This guy goes, so hiking date later today, ? That's actually a pretty good idea. Like, hiking for a date, it's actually a good move, especially in today's climate. I mean, yeah, you can go like bowling, I guess, depending on the state, but there really aren't that many activities. So the hiking idea isn't too shabby. But she goes, all right, so I have to cancel because I'm not in Virginia right now. Sorry. He goes, oh, that's okay. Where are you at? She goes, visiting a friend all the way in Michigan. And he goes, fun. But apparently this guy had Steph's location and pulled it up. And apparently she was in Virginia. Down bad, man. Down bad. I mean, that's just tough. Like, she just didn't want to hang with you that day, man. Maybe you gotta figure something else out because hiking may or may not be the wave for this girl. All right, this next one, I don't know who like texts with the iMessage subject line, but hey, maybe I'm just a weirdo. I don't use that at all. But yeah, this girl goes, I don't know, bro, I'm just annoyed. When you get called bro or dude or buddy or pal, like, it's already a done deal. Don't try to get out of that field or that force field, as I should call it, of the friend zone. You're already there. Like, it's really hard to get out of it. So then she goes, all men need to leave me alone. Ha, not you though, you don't count. He goes, LMAO, my bad. And why don't I count? I'm a man. She goes, forget it, you too now. Nah, you're one of the girlies. Oh, shoot. Ah, that stings, man. Like, I mean, I already saw where this was going with the I don't know, bro. Like, usually if a girl's interested in you, she doesn't call you bro, buddy, pal. She's definitely hinting at something there. But he goes, oh, and she laughs with the ha-ha reaction. You hate to see it. This last one is not too shabby. It's actually hilarious. You know, apparently the Instagram DMs are the wave. I don't know. We've gone through more of those than I think the iMessage ones, but who's counting, right? So this guy's texting Morgan or DMing Morgan through Instagram. He goes, hey, you want to come to my birthday party this weekend? She goes, I have COVID, so I can't leave my room. Sorry. And, you know, at the end of the day, this is a common excuse girls will use to not go to the dating scene. If you're willing to hang out with somebody, you're already, like, kind of risking it. But if she goes, I have COVID, she could be telling the truth, but it's also an excuse girls can use now to basically turn down a date. And, you know, you can take it seriously, but if, like I said before, you're trying to actually go out and date, then yeah, you are risking it, but at the same time, you know, use precautions, I guess, is the right way to say it. But she goes, I have COVID, so I can't leave my room. He goes, it's okay, it's on Zoom. So I guess he's just partying over Zoom. You know, it is what it is, right? Like, some people don't want to take that risk. But she goes, I don't have a Zoom. Damn, like, I don't know, man. That's just tough. Like, she doesn't want to even go on Zoom. I mean, it's kind of a weird thing to begin with. Why are you inviting this girl to come on to Zoom for a birthday party type of thing? I feel like if I ever were to do this situation or do this scenario for my birthday, and, you know, let's say, you know, COVID is still a real thing by the summer, because that's when my birthday is, then if I were to have a Zoom call, I would only have like my close circle of friends. I don't know if I would invite some random girl that I've been hitting up through the Instagram DMs to come and join, right? So, I mean, dudes are down bad. Like, it wasn't as bad as the first episode, but these girls have no remorse. Like, if you are not in their, I guess, in list per se, you're just going to get slaughtered. You're gonna get the Mike Tyson 1-2. You're gonna get the Evander Holyfield haymakers. It's just tough out here. Like, you guys need to just figure out when, you know, a girl calls you buddy or pal, or when a girl's just saying, I can't hang out, I'm in another state. Meanwhile, she's in the same state as you. Like, it's just tough out here for these dudes. So I hope you all did enjoy this video. Don't forget to drop a like, subscribe if you guys are new to the channel, and comment down below which one you think was your favorite. I think the first one, to be honest with you, that was a pretty tough situation with the group chat. But yeah, I'm Cryptix. Definitely not down bad in the Instagram DMs. And signing off.